name is Big Dre 20. What you see here are my two custom Big Dre 20 alternators, 370 amps from Autotech Engineering. I have those charging 135 amp hours of Honda Insight cells. Lithium bank I built myself. Got four runs of 2-watt welding cable. Two runs of power, two runs of ground going to the back. Right now I'm going to display the meter results and power from the amplifier and the kick. Got the SPL Labs wireless base meter, the third edition, and the kick. So the dB numbers you see are going to be in the kick area of my 2007 Chevy Tahoe. It's LTZ. This is my 135 amp hour lithium bank that I built myself with custom Rick and Morty bus bars from Coventry Industries. Shouts out to them. Got an enclosure. It's not done, it's not painted. I gotta figure out what I'm gonna do with it, but I built this enclosure myself for my six custom Soundstream XXX 15s with Pierce Audio Products soft parts. They have dual 1.4 ohm voice coils. They're 4-inch and 8-layer as well, with carbon fiber dust caps. Nothing on them yet till I finalize everything. Right now, this is gonna be a little test of my Soundstream XXX 15000D. This is the enclosure with the three 10-inch aero ports from Big Ass Ports. It's currently tuned to 35 hertz. The subs are rated around 4,000 RMS each. And right now we're testing the Soundstream XXX 15000D. I'm gonna test it to the six XXXs at 0.47 right now. That's 0.053 lower than, excuse the calls. That's 0.03 lower than 0.5. I'm gonna be testing that. Then see how this amplifier does, what kind of power we get, and how loud it is on the meter and the kick. So I got the clamp meter hooked up to the SPL Labs wireless base meter. Got the positive and negative leads on the cables here, using 10 gauge for the subwoofers. And right now, every window and door will be sealed off, even the driver's side. But I'm gonna leave the driver door open. So everything's sealed, driver door open. Volume is gonna be at 48, because that's where it's tuned to with zero distortion with the SMD DD1. I'm gonna do the TAR amps 12MD12000.1, wire it the same, zero distortion with the DD1 as well. Make sure the settings on my head unit is the same. Subwoofer level is zero, and then the EQ is all zeroed out as well. Just making sure everything is the same, so you know, I can see what's the best these amplifiers have to offer for my system. Just a full-blown comparison to see, even though it's a 12,000 versus a 15,000, we're still talking about a Brazilian amplifier versus some old tech right here. This is like a big two-channel. All right, so let's see what happens. Gonna be testing this with my old LG Stylo 4 phone. I only use this for testing purposes. Right now we're gonna test 30 hertz. So we're gonna do 30. 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, and 60 hertz during this test. And I'm gonna do the same thing with the TAR amps MD12000.1 to see which one between the frequencies of 30 to 60 hertz is louder. So at 30 hertz, did a 155.3 dB with a total watts of 13,174.3. So that's how much wattage it did to do a 155.3 dB at 30 hertz. So I'm gonna reset this meter. And next, we're gonna try 35 hertz. Bear with me, this video will be pretty long. It's all testing purposes. But I hope you guys enjoy it. So at 35 hertz, we did a 158.7 dB in the kick with 13,050.4 watts clamped. Sorry, sometimes I get getting a little stumbled with my words here, but this is all power out of the Soundstream Triple X 15,000D at 0.47. So next we're gonna reset the meter here and we're gonna try 40 hertz. I'm gonna do the same exact testing with the Tar-Amps MD12000.1 after we finish here with this. All right. So as you see at 40 hertz, we did a 158.4 dB in the kick. So they're just a few tenths or whatnot quieter than 35 hertz and almost 3,000 watts lower, with a total of 10,840.7 watts clamp. I'm not writing down these results, I'm just kind of looking on screen, but it took over 13,000 and some change at 35 hertz to make just roughly louder than 40 hertz. And this is exactly why we test. I don't know it all, I'm learning, so doing things like this is fun and definitely a learning experience for myself, and I hope it is for others. So we're gonna now do 45 hertz. Alright. Oh, okay, yeah, sorry about that. I was just doing a little video for my channel. All right, well, at 45 hertz, we got, that's the police, everyone. Yeah, they just came up and told me I had to keep it down. So, unfortunately, I'm going to have to try to continue this video some other time. But at 45 hertz, did a 157.3 dB with 12,731 watts clamped. All right, everyone, I'm sorry. I can't turn it up here on out. Right now, they're letting me off with a warning. And if I continue, then it's gonna seem like I'm just being disrespectful and I don't want any issues here. I'm at the park doing my testing. And, you know, I might not be doing a 160, but a high 50s is still pretty loud. So I'm gonna stop the video here. I hope you all like what you've seen up to this point. I'll try to get some more video footage later, and stay tuned for more. As always, thanks for watching. Peace and love. All right, everyone. This is me continuing with the testing from 30 to 50 hertz. Settings are still the same. I had to stop the testing because the police came over to the park, took my location, and basically asked me to keep the music down. So I'm continuing at a different location here. Everything's still the same. Everything's zeroed out on the EQ. It's still zero right here. So I'm still gonna, everything's the same, but I don't wanna stay here too long at this location. Everything's sealed off, except for the driver door, the same as previous testing. I was able to get from 30 hertz to 45 hertz. So right now I'm only gonna finish with 50, 55, and 60. And then I'm going to add this video to the results of the previous. The testing of the Soundstream Triple X 15,000D at 0.47 to the 6 Soundstream Triple X 15s with the Pierce Audio Products soft parts. So let's try 50 hertz. Just continuing from the previous testing. And let's see what happens. Alright, so at 50 hertz, did a 157.4 dB in the kick with 14,265 watts clamped. And this is the most I've ever seen out of this amplifier, so very impressed. So now we're going to do 55 hertz. All right. So at 55 hertz, we did a 158 even in the kick with 13,981.6 watts clamped. And now we're going to end it at 60 hertz. So, 60 hertz. All right, so at 60 hertz, did a 158.5 dBs with 13,218.4 watts clamped. So that's going to end the video now. With the testing of the Soundstream XXX 15,000D at 0.47. I'm going to take this amplifier out and I'm going to put the Tar Amps MD12000.1 in the 0.5 ohm version, same ohm load, test it with the DD1, the SMD DD1 for zero distortion. I'm going to use the same phone with the same app for testing, and I'm going to do 30 to 60 hertz with that amplifier to see which one is loudest from my system. Hope you all like what you've seen. As always, stay tuned for more, and thanks for watching.